Hello everyone, in this session we are going to discuss about the types of chromosomes based on the position of centromere and based on the number of centromere. So in the previous session we have already discussed the morphology of the chromosomes and what do you mean by chromosome number. So let's go to the what are the types of chromosomes. So this is the classification of chromosomes based on the position of the centromere. So as you can see, the centromere in the first one, that is the telocentric chromosome, the centromere is placed and they are having arms, that is chromosome arms, they are stretched and they are of same size and they are mainly present in one side. So that is how the telocentric chromosomes look like. And the acrocentric, where one arm is very much elongated and one arm is very much condensed. So you can tell P and Q arm. So usually they are very much smaller. One, they are very much smaller, that is P arms, they are very much smaller, and Q arm are much elongated. But when coming to the submetacentric chromosomes, so there what happens? The P arm is much larger when compared to the acrocentric, or you can tell the P arm is half of the Q arm in the submetacentric. But whereas in metacentric, both P arm and Q arm are of same size and the centromere is in the center portion. So this is how the classification of chromosomes based on the position of the centromere. So telocentric, what happens? The centromere is located at the end of the chromosome, and such chromosomes are very much rare and it exists normally in certain species of protozoans. Acrocentric chromosomes, so what happens? These are rod-like chromosomes and they are having a very small arm and very long arm. So P arm and Q arm can be easily distinguished by having very much smaller arm and larger. So this is the characteristic which we can see in locusts, that is in insects. Submetacentric, so here these chromosomes are L-shaped and they are having unequal arm. So P arm and Q arm, they can differentiate, but when compared to acrocentric, the Q arm is much larger. Sorry, the P arm is much larger. Metacentric, usually they are V-shaped and they are equal sized. And these chromosomes, they are mainly the characteristics of amphibia. So that is called as the metacentric chromosomes. So coming to the classification of chromosomes depending on the number of centromere. So centromere, if it is a single, only one centromere is present, that is called as monocentric chromosome. If they are having two centromeres, it is called as dicentric. If you are having more than two, then it is called as polycentric. If there is no centromere, then it is called as the acentric centromere. So these are the two different types of classification of chromosomes depending on the number of centromere and position of centromere. So this can be asked for 5 marks. So depending, so if they ask write a note on classification of chromosome, you need to write both, like including depending on the number of centromere and the position of the centromere. If they are asking specifically, usually they will be asking on the position of the centromere. So then you have to write the, with the neat label diagram, you need to show how the different types of chromosomes on the basis of the chromosomes or the position of the centromere. And last concept in this talk, that is the genome. So genome is nothing but the complete set of DNA which includes the information. So the genome contains all the information needed to build the organism. For example, genome, I can tell it is a mixture of both father and mother's genes, and that may cause the genome. So in humans, our genome entire thing, it has got 3 billion DNA base pairs which contains in all the cells, and they have the nucleus. So they can ask the definition for the genome. So it is nothing but the organism which is having complete set of DNA and which also helps in or which also contains the information and also helps in the building and maintaining the organism. So that's about this session. So here in this session we have discussed about the morphology based on the structure and position, and one more type, that is based on the number of centromere, and what is genome. So that's about this session. Thank you.